When I was a kid, we were allowed to grow something in the garden each year. This particular year, my choice was corn. I mean, look at this thing. So my mum took me to buy a packet of corn seeds, and I was pretty happy thinking of all the corn heading my way. But when I opened the packet, I was shocked. These seeds, after a bit of a wash, just looked like dehydrated, unpopped popcorn. I decided to try growing them anyway. And because I was curious, I also planted a few popcorn kernels. And 2 weeks later, both had grown. Whoa! Since then, I've always wondered, what other seeds from the kitchen will grow in the garden? If you're curious about this too, then stick around and let's find out. Are you ready? Then let's get scienced. To try this at home, you'll need seedling pots or an egg carton, potting mix, a small spray bottle, clear wrap, pop sticks, and of course, some seeds from the kitchen. Finding the seeds hidden in your kitchen is the best part. Have a look at your spices. You might have seeds for black pepper, coriander, cumin, fennel, mustard, and sesame. Then take a look in your pantry to see if you have brown rice, popcorn, buckwheat, and barley. Or maybe even a few beans, like black-eyed beans, chickpeas, balotti beans, lentils, and white beans. You don't need all of these, and you might find some other seeds or beans, which you should go ahead and try. Once you've collected the seeds and beans, fill the seedling pots with potting mix and place a pop stick, labelled with their names, into each pot. We're now ready to plant them. A general rule is to plant the seeds at a depth 2 times their width. For the smaller seeds, just press them below the surface of the soil. And for the beans, try planting them 2.5 centimeters deep. This next step is pretty important. We need to water the soil so that it's wet, but not soaked. Once you've watered them, loosely cover the seedling pots with clear plastic wrap to create a miniature greenhouse. Then place the seeds in a warm location, avoiding direct sunlight, as this can kill the seedlings. For the next 2 weeks, I checked on the seeds each morning. When I did this, I gave them another spray of water to keep the soil wet. Let's look at the results. For the first 3 days, nothing happened. But then, on day 4, the mustard seed sprouted. The buckwheat, lentils, popcorn, and white beans all sprouted on day 5. And on day 6, the barley joined them. On day 7, both the chickpeas and brown rice started to sprout. Day 8 was also a pretty busy day, with the balotti beans, the coriander, and even a single sesame seed all sprouting. No new seeds sprouted on day 9, and on day 10, the black-eyed beans became the last to sprout. I kept checking right up until day 14, so a full 2 weeks since starting the experiment, but the black pepper, cumin, and fennel never sprouted. So out of the 15 seeds and beans that I planted, 12 of them sprouted. It's possible that the seeds that didn't grow had been sterilized to prevent them from growing. After all, if a little bit of water got into these spice jars or into this pepper shaker, the last thing you'd want is for a plant to grow. Of course, you might get slightly different results when you try this in your country, but that's what makes it a fun experiment. Once you've finished with this experiment, you can plant the seedlings in the garden or place them in the compost bin. It's up to you, but let me know your results. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time on Silly Science with Simon.